I'm Dr. Alivelu Kasturi from India. I'm working as an associate professor in the Center for Economic and Social Studies, which is a research organization. I basically work on industrial economics, and then off late I've diversified into water and sanitation, which is again the Sustainable Development Goal 6 of 2030.
I'm András Nagy. I'm from Hungary, Budapest, and I'm working for the Ministry of Finance at the Budget Department, actually besides by the Deputy State Secretary responsible for budgetary affairs. I'm his head of secretariat.
My name is Beki Gutra. I'm from South Africa. I'm based in Pretoria, so I work for government in the Ministry of Finance in a space called Office of the Accountant General. But my line of function is in risk management, so that's what I basically do. I do risk management for the country.
My name is Silvi Hafianti. I'm from Indonesia. I work as a researcher in Definit. It's a research institute that conducted training, capacity building, and consulting, and also research, dealing with development issues or economics issues. So both are covered in that in the area that we are working on. We are in the private sector, so we are not related to government sector, but we do work, or we have clients that work for the government. So we do works for the Ministry of Finance, we do work for international institutions such as World Bank, but as a company, we are like a private sector in this case.
For me, sustainable development is my behavior or my actions. That is, what I do today should not compromise the future needs or the needs of the future generations. Then when it comes to social sustainability, I think I'll talk about all-inclusiveness or the tolerance towards the other social groups. Then also I will talk about the equality concept. I'm working on water and sanitation, and if there is inadequate water, if there is no quality water, and if you do not have access to water, that is, if you have to go for long distance to fetch your water, what are the implications on the health of the individuals, and what are the economic implications? Women fetch more water. That means that they're cutting down their time on going for economic activity. So that is again showing on the living conditions of the household, because the woman is not able to contribute to her household. So there's a decline in the living standards of the family. I'll also talk about the school-going children. The children are not able to go to school because they have to fetch water. Their time is gone in fetching water and they are not going to the school.
We are keen on encouraging those kind of projects which are aligned with all the different aspects of sustainability, economic, environmental, social, regarding how to make greener the office. We could make changes inside the office, very concrete changes like making alerts and making notes to colleagues to shut down the computer, shut down the electricity, and similar. But my favorite was that we would able to buy some bicycles for the staff, and in that way enable and encourage them to go from one ministry to other agency or between ministries, between meetings, with bicycles and not with taxi.
The social aspect, the economic aspect, and the environmental aspect. So it's looking at that. So on a daily basis, we're looking at that, which is to look at the development of the policies and the frameworks in the space of risk management. So we developed that in understanding of the national plan, which we call it in South Africa, National Development Plan. And that National Development Plan is in line with the global agenda.
At the end, we will give contribution to how to achieve the sustainable development. We have work on how to increase financial access for the disabled people, they do have this burden, that the obstacle that they cannot have access to financial institution, which at the end also make them difficult to get to have access to financial products such as savings or credit, for example. In some way, it also doing a work or providing a way to strengthen the development, sustainable development, perhaps in the area of economic aspect and also in social aspect.
The data which I analyze would be useful to the policymakers. Like, I would be able to tell that this is the locality which requires more of water. This is a locality which requires more of sanitation. And in scarce situations like summer, what additional policies should the government take to see that water or sanitation is on par with the demand of the individuals?
Being aligned with the European Union's criteria as well, like the Maastricht criteria, most importantly for us, the budget deficit, which always should be below 3%, and even decreasing. Between those boundaries, we are trying to, as I mentioned at the beginning, trying to encourage those kind of projects which are at the same time aligned with the sustainable goals.
The role that we play is largely in the area where we are part of the policy development, looking at the allocation of the budget in a sense that it's going to promote and support the implementation of the sustainable development goals.
In doing research, for example, we are most of the time we're trying to find a way to why this sustainable development goals or the sustainable development aspect have not been reached in Indonesia yet. So we make the pathway, we make the workflow. We also try to have access to be able to train either the policymakers or change makers that they understand about the importance of reaching the sustainable development goals.
We in the country, we have forums or platforms where different sectors engage in around the agenda of the SDGs. The public sector, which is us as government. Number two is the private sector, that is business and civil society. However, I think that can be improved. What we've noticed currently is that, or at the moment, is that the private sector and the civil society have taken some strides in engaging and implementing part of the SDGs, whereas public sector is sort of like left behind. So what needs to be done now is a more inclusive forum that will allow the participation of everybody, where government plays a critical role, and it has to be led by government as a policymaker of the country.
Regarding the different boards we've got for subsidizing investment, where we can have a serious impact upon what kind of investments are suggested to us to be implemented in the industrial area, like building factories and doing that kind of investments in different parts of Hungary. Another important aspect besides the environmental and the economic aspect, the social aspect of sustainability. So we are trying to focus on that kind of areas of Hungary where there is still available workforce.
In a way, we're trying to be a hub for many sectors that can work together and to solve the issues that are matters for Indonesia.
The vision would be the wash, water, sanitation and hygiene, and how it will lead to the economic development of the society as a whole.
We are now in years in my country, and I suppose in the European Union as well, when there is economic growth. I would be happy if we could reach in my field, in my country, those times when the deficit can be like zero or reaching that reasonably, more reasonably that now we are doing that, because that would mean that we are not financing ourselves basing upon loans, but we are just spending the resources which are available for us based upon our resources. And we can make preserves for other times. More space for being adaptable, being flexible, resilient to the future hard times.
Of course, if we talk about vision, we always want to see that those goals in sustainable development will be achieved in each country, because that's the ideal condition. In my personal opinion, for Indonesia, now the most important things to start this is to have to make them aware of that there's these goals that are set in the international level for all countries that are ensure that people are not left behind. We are determined to reach this goal as a country, and the governments already have this desire to reach that goal. So, but sometimes what the government level understand or wants to do doesn't translate it into the understanding in the lower level, for example, in the private sector or to other sector. The precondition for that is to have a common eye level understanding about the issues, so that after that we can move forward to set a target or set a plan that might work in the case for Indonesia.